Okay, I think we should put the lid over that.
Okay, we'll do that.
Even though you said it's not necessary.
I was going to put it on here and just let it have a little walk around. Do you want just to skip that bit?
Karen? I'll skip that bit, yes.
Okay, then.
I'll definitely skip that.
In that case, what I'll do is, just for you...
Thank you.
We'll lock that up and look at something...
Less dangerous.
...far easier. Okay, let's look at something a little friendly. Okay, now I know that you'll love this...
Right, okay.
Okay. Now here we have another little friend.
That's okay. Coming towards me.
Okay. And here we have a scorpion. Now this is a lobster scorpion from Africa. Okay. Now these large rainforest scorpions produce venom from this area here called the telson. Uh-huh. And you have a needle there which inoculates the venom, a bit like a hypodermic needle. Okay. Now, in the case of these large rainforest scorpions, they are not as aggressive as the smaller, more venomous boothid scorpions, which tend to be far more dangerous. And that is because in the rainforest, there's plenty of water.
Mm-hmm.
And because there's a lot more water, the venom is far more dilute.
Right.
Whereas the boothid scorpions tend to come mainly from drier desert areas where there is less water and therefore the venom is more concentrated.
Oh, okay. So if you didn't have hold of its tail there, would it be trying to...
It's quite likely it would sting.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, do you want to just demonstrate that for us, Karen?
No. Okay. I don't mind if you do.
Okay, right. Well, let's put him away and let's look at a boothid scorpion.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now here we have an interesting desert scorpion. Right, okay, let's just put that there. Okay, and here we have a rather faster...
Don't like the colour of that one.
More venomous species, okay? Now, we can see that the claws are much sharper on this one.
Yeah, at the
end there.
Yeah.
Okay, and it's far more aggressive. And you can see that it's far more inclined to sting, okay, than the larger one. And there you have it. You have two very interesting scorpions.
You get hold of that.
I was going to let it come a bit closer because I wanted to see that psychological reaction, Karen. But we'll do that next time, off air.
I think Maria Jose is going to be on next time.
Right, okay. I'll bring in some hamsters then, shall I?
Yeah, probably better.
Right, okay. Well, so as you can see, this is a different scorpion. Now, if we compare it with the other scorpion, let's just have a little peek at this scorpion. It's quite different.
Oh, very different.
The claws are quite different. Mm. The body shape morphologically is quite different. And therefore, this is also a lot slower.
Mm.
And there is the desert scorpion is a lot faster. Okay, this scorpion can be found during the day as well. Okay, because being a diurnal species as well as nocturnal, they do come out in the evening, but you can't see them during the day hunting. Because the rainforest is reasonably dark anyway.
Mm.
Whereas this scorpion is completely nocturnal because the deserts are very hot.
Yes.
During the day, and they come out only at night time when the air is cooler to hunt.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And also, their venom is far more potent because they don't want to waste energy with struggling prey. So the venom is quite potent. It acts quickly in killing the prey.
Okay.
Whereas the larger scorpions don't always use their telson for killing their prey. A lot of the times, they are able to use their very large, powerful claws just to crush their prey.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's interesting.
So there you go.
Ooh, I feel a bit happier now. We'll do in a minute anyway.
Two interesting creatures there. Right.
Ooh, okay. That one doesn't want to go in. And of course, you've got some lovely images as well. I call them lovely images because they're not crawling about on the table. And
that's right.
Yeah, you're going to be talking to us about some more poisonous creatures. One of them being the death stalker.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the one.
Yes. Well, I mean, just having a look at scorpions. This is another boothid scorpion. Now, today's topic is natural born killers.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, here we have an interesting scorpion that I photographed and studied in ancient Egypt.
Yeah.
Now, the death stalker is known scientifically as Lieras kinkestriatus hebreus.
Oh,
try
that's
saying
a mouthful.
That after a couple of vodkas. Lieras is the world's most deadly scorpion. And this, hence why it's called the Death Stalker. And when I was in Egypt, I had the locals collecting them for me because they knew that there was a doctor here who was working on venomous animals. And rumour just spread throughout the West Bank. And the West Bank was, I was basically staying at the Winter Palace hotel. And I was two doors down, by the way, from the room where Agatha Christie had written her book, Death on the Nile.
Oh, right.
And from my balcony, you could see the inspiration that she must have had overlooking the beautiful River Nile. And across the road, you catch the felucca, which are the little boats, and you go across the River Nile, and you come to the West Bank. This is where the shanty towns are, and these kind of mud brick houses with straw-thatched roofs. Mm. And the scorpions tend to live in these walls, and they come out at night time. And the villagers tend to kill them as soon as they see them, because if they sting a child or an elderly person or anybody really, they can cause death. Oh,
okay.
And for that reason, they were bringing me these scorpions that had been squished, that either trampled on them or hit them with the stick. I said, no, I want them alive. And they were totally mystified why I wanted them alive. But I did get some specimens at the end of the day. But then there was the time I actually did get to study some of the tombs in the Valley of Kings. That was quite interesting.
Yeah,
and I was promptly arrested for using my camera. But that's a completely different story.
Oh, we'll catch up with next time. Travels with Dr. Venom. We'll have a different program. And the next one is a pit viper.
Okay, well, again, natural-born killers. Mm. A pit viper, this one is the Malaysian pit viper. Here we have a juvenile specimen. Pit vipers are one of the most dangerous snakes in the world and produce a very virulent venom, but they also have very large fangs, as vipers tend to do. Quite interesting when you're collecting them, I must say, because we tend to use the snake hook in order to collect them. Uh-huh. And I've actually found that venomous vipers, although they are aggressive, tend to be slightly easier to handle than venomous colubrids, but that might be just a personal thing. In England, I've collected adders quite easily, and I've not really found them to be that aggressive.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I'll take your word for it. And of course, our next one, which you brought in before, actually into the studio, is the Black Widow. Yeah.
Yes. Well, here we have Latrodectus tridecima cathartis. Okay, this is the Mediterranean.
Sounds like supercalifragilistic.
I can't say that. I can say the Latrodectus tridecima cathartis, or I can't say the other one. And this is, again, a black widow spider that belongs to the Latrodectus genus. Latrodectus spiders, or black widows as they are known, are found all over the tropical and temperate parts of the world. And we are so lucky to have this beautiful spider here in Andalusia. Mm-hmm. Isn't that so exciting?
Yes, as long as you don't sort of like accidentally tread on it or put your hand on it.
No, I mean, if you tread on it, it's not going to be dangerous anyway, because you know, it cannot penetrate a shoe.
Okay. But what about sandal?
I've never tried it. They're found in webs that are known as tangle webs, and as soon as you touch these webs, it alerts the spider and it goes into hunting mode, because the vibrations cause the spider to come out and attack.
Uh-huh.
So that's when the spider is at his most dangerous, when it's actually inside the tangle web.
Right.
But on this show, I've actually handled black widows.
Yes,
and
you have.
Once they're out of the tangle web, they're not as aggressive.
Because they're not protecting their home.
As they would be. However, yeah. I'm still taking a risk when handling them, because obviously if it does bite, they do have a pretty virulent venom. And they are one of the most dangerous spiders in the world.
And what would be the antidote?
There isn't one.
There isn't one?
No. The antivenin for Latrodectus tridecima cathartis is now no longer produced in Europe,
right,
because it was too expensive. The process was too expensive to produce it. So for the actual treatment of Latrodectus bites, you will need to read the book.
Uh-huh.
But in extreme cases, it is an intravenous dose of 10% solution of calcium gluconate.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you very much. And just reminding everybody that at the Timisa Golf Hotel on the 26th of June, Dr. Venom will be there from 10:30 in the morning. He's going to be signing his book, Poisonous Insects.
Poisonous Creatures.
Poisonous
of
Creatures
the Mediterranean.
Of the Mediterranean. And the details are there on the screen. And we'll keep reminding you about it as well. There's going to be a lecture. There's going to be workshops. You can actually have your photograph taken with some of these insects. So that will be interesting.